name of this song is Pound for a Brown. You ready? One, two, three, four. We'll be right back. Frosted beard, the ground below was 100 degrees below zero. And my mama cried,
"You don't really look like an Eskimo."
And my mama cried one more time,
"You don't really look like an Eskimo."
My mama cried again,
"You don't really look like an Eskimo." Nanook, no, no. Nanook, no, no. Don't be a naughty Eskimo.
Show. Well, I turned around and I said, "Ho, ho." Well, I turned around and I said, "Ho, ho." Well, I turned around and I said again, "Ho, ho." And the northern lights commenced to glow. Watch out where the huskies go, and don't you eat that yellow snow. Watch out where the huskies go, and don't you eat that yellow snow. Right about that time, people, a fur trapper who was strictly from commercial
strictly commercial
had the unmitigated audacity to jump up from behind my igloo.
Peekaboo.
And it started into whipping on my favorite baby seal with a lead-filled snowshoe.
That's right, with a lead.
Lead-filled snowshoe.
Snowshoe.
He said peekaboo.
Peekaboo.
With a
lead-filled.
With a lead-filled snowshoe.
Snowshoe.
He said peekaboo.
Peekaboo.
Yes, he went right upside the head of my favorite baby seal. He hit him on the nose. He hit him on the fin. He went whap. And that got me just about as evil as an Eskimo boy can be. And so, I bent down and I reached down and I scooped down and I gathered up a generous mitten full of the deadly
yellow snow.
The deadly yellow snow from right there where the huskies go. And then I proceeded to rub it all into his beady little eyes with a vigorous circular motion hitherto unknown to the citizens of Manchester, but destined to take the place of the mud shark in your mythology. Here it goes, a vigorous circular motion. Here it goes, rub it!
Hey. Hey.
Now listen to this. This is the most important part of the show. And I'll bet you'll never guess what it involves. Well, I'll tell you just to save time. This is the part of the show where we have what we call in the trade audience
participation.
Now, I don't want this to cause alarm among you, but you are going to
participate in this show.
And here's how you're going to do it. What I'm going to ask you to do may at first seem really stupid, but if you think about it a while, you'll discover that it is, in fact, totally stupid. And that's the best reason for doing it. Now, all you have to do is do what I do, and I'm going to do. And I'm going to do even more stupid things to amuse you. Only this time, you're going to participate in it. Now here's the first thing you do. Stand up. Go ahead, don't be shy. Up, up you go. Very good. Okay, now watch how stimulating this is, okay? I'll do it first just for rehearsal, right? Now you pounce. You pounce again. Jump up and down the chest of a... Great googly moogly, you're going to help me into this fur trapper. Are you ready? I told you it was stupid and I wasn't lying, was I? Ready? Okay, here we go. Now you pounce. You pounce again. Jump up and down the chest of a... Now some of you aren't jumping up and down the chest of a fast enough. Now look, let's work on that one little part. You can't sit down yet, no. Let's get the fast ones together, okay? Jump up and down the chest of a... 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 Oh, that's as good as it's gonna get. Sit down. Thank you for participating in our show tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Manchester Still Life, live on parade. Okay, now, the fur trapper, he was really fucked up. He had the entire contents of this audience jumping up and down on the chest of a, and so forth. And as you all know, that can really hurt a guy.
Yeah.
That's right. And so, therefore, he looked around. Looked around again, and he looked around one more time, and he said, I can't see,
no, yeah.
I can't see,
no,
I can't see,
no,
I can't see, he took a dog. Do snow cone and stuffed it in my right eye. He took a dog, do snow cone and stuffed it in my other eye. And the husky wee wee, I mean the doggy wee wee, has blinded me. And I can't see. Temporarily, that's right, you got the drift. Well, look, it was at this time that he remembered the ancient and venerable Eskimo legend, wherein it is written on whatever it is that they write it on up there, that if anything bad ever happens to your eyes, it results in some sort of a conflict with any kind of an audience in Manchester, the only way that you can get it fixed up is to go trudging across the tundra. Trudging across the tundra. That's right. Mile after mile. Here, you sing it. Everybody. That's right. Hey, all right. It's almost like being in the real world. Now, you have to go trudging across the tundra mile after mile. I'm translating from the French over here. Mile after mile, all the way down to the parish of St. Alphonso. Now, as you know, I can tell from the astute look on each and every one of your faces that you already realize that St. Alphonso is and shall continue to be the patron saint of the smelt fishermen of Portuguese extraction. And so, verily I say unto you, it is time for Ed Mann to play the big lick that takes each and every one of you down to the parish of St. Alphonso. Take it away, Ed! No, don't take that away, Ed. We'll be right back. here we are at St. Alphonso's Pancake Breakfast, where I stole the margarine and wheedled on the bingo cards in lieu of the latrine. I saw a handsome parish lady make her entrance like a queen. Why, she was totally chenille and her old man was a marine.
Now,
as she abused the sausage patties and said, why don't you treat me mean? St. Alphonso's Pancake Breakfast. How good God, get off the bus.
Well, I stole the margarine.
Father Vivian, old Vivian, resplendent in his frock, was whipping up the batter for the pancakes of his flock. He was looking rather bleary, he forgot to watch the clock, cause the night before, behind the door, leprechaun had strolled. He stroked it. The night before, behind the door, leprechaun had strolled. He stroked it. The night before, behind the door, leprechaun had strolled. He smiled. Stroked his smock, set him off in such a frenzy, he sang Walk Around the Clock. And it topped it off with a, and it topped it off with a, and it topped it off with a boo-boo-boo, boo-boo-boo, boo-boo-boo. As he stumbled on his cock, he was delighted as it stiffened and ripped right through his sock. Oh, St. Alphonso would be proud of me. He shouted down the block. Thumb and his vote is gone, that conspiracy too old. Won't you eat my sleazy pancakes just for St. Alphonso? This old life is lovely wife, we'll raise a fortune by tonight. This old life is lovely wife, we'll raise a fortune by tonight. This old life is lovely brown, they're the finest in the town. This old life is lovely brown, they're the finest in the town. Good morning, your highness. Good morning, your highness.
Really loves it when he rubs it for him.
I have seen him rubbing it. I have seen him rubbing it. I have seen him stroke his weenie. It was teeny.
Rub it, rub it, rub it, rub it, rub. Nanook rubs it, Alfie loves it. Nanook rubs it, Alfie loves it. Nanook rubs it, Alfie loves it. Nanook is rubbing it and Alfie is loving it. praying to you. Can you fix my Chevy? Boy, you're really heavy. Here's the church and here's the steeple. Open up and see the people. Some are kneeling, some are standing. All the money they are handing to some asshole with a basket. Where it goes, we dare not ask it.
Mikey, Tommy, Eddie, Petey, Vinny, Artie, and Sophia Warren on guitar. Thanks for coming to the show. Hope you liked it, and good night.